Hello, welcome to the video where I explain all about healing reactions. Now, healing reactions are very weird and wonderful things, and you can have them with all sorts of modalities and treatments, but this video is specifically about Heilkunst healing reactions. So with Heilkunst healing reactions, generally you're going to get them with the powder. So when you come to see me, you will get generally a dropper or several droppers and also powders. So the droppers are nice and gentle and they lap away at things, they support you. The powders are gonna pack more of a punch. So when you take the powders, generally about 9 days afterwards, sometimes people who are very sensitive can actually have healing reactions while they're taking the powders, but in general, it will be about 9 days after taking the powders, you can have what's called a healing reaction. So what I recommend to people is if they're having some weird and wonderful symptoms come up, to look and see when they took their last set of powders. If it was about 9 or 10 days ago, then chances are what you're experiencing is a healing reaction and it will pass in about 3 or 4 days. So a useful thing, I actually have a client who keeps a Heilkunst calendar, and so she'll write down what powder she took when, and then she can go back and look at the calendar and, oh, I'm having a healing reaction, this should pass in a few days. With the healing reactions, generally a really neat thing to do is to look and see what powders you've taken and what they're for. If they're physical powders, oftentimes a person can have, you know, a return of old symptoms. So take, for example, a person doing a set of powders for possibly a whiplash injury. They could have their neck flare up for a few days as a healing reaction. Or if you had, actually I had one lady, we had treated her for the birth of her daughter, and for 3 days she was having symptoms that felt a lot like she was in labor or giving birth. And so she was reliving that in the healing reaction. And that was kind of an extreme example, but that can happen. And also if you're taking emotional powders can bring up those emotions. So say you were taking Natmir powders, which is our unresolved grief powders, it can bring up grief. And so you can feel a lot like having a good cry. And so that's the best thing you can do is just to go with it, let those emotions come up, honor them, and let yourself cry. Or if you're doing anger powders, let yourself get angry, maybe do some of my anger releasing exercises to help you get through that. But really with a healing reaction, the best thing to do is to let it ride. You don't want to shut it down. So the body is bringing these symptoms or these emotions up so that you can release them and heal. And the stronger the healing reaction, the bigger the shift or the bigger the healing afterwards. So after you've been in Heilkunst treatment for a while, you will start to actually get disappointed when you don't have a big reaction from a set of powders. So you do start to get used to the healing reactions and you get used to riding the waves because you know it's only gonna last a few days. So like I said, that Heilkunst calendar can be really useful to help give you some perspective and even get you excited about the process and think, oh, I'm just having a healing reaction and I'm feeling these powders, so that's good. I'm gonna have a big shift afterwards and know that they only last about 3 or 4 days. So if you have any weird or wonderful symptoms going on, because the healing reaction can bring up all sorts of interesting and unusual symptoms. So yeah, if you take a look and see when you took your last set of powders, if it was, you know, within that 9 to 14 day range, chances are you're having a healing reaction. And like I said, sensitive constitutions can also have reactions while they're taking the powders. That happens as well, and then they will tend to have another reaction again about 9 days afterwards. But the people who have the biggest reactions, I see really big shifts in them too. So I mean, it can be tougher to go through treatment, but you can have fantastic shifts and fantastic healing from that as well. So that's the upside of it. So if you have some unusual symptoms that you're not sure about, if you haven't taken powders recently, or if they last longer than 3 or 4 days, then that's something to look into. But generally, these healing reaction symptoms will go away on their own after a few days. And then again, after you've done your powder, what will happen is you'll have sort of this charge, this discharge phase. So you'll have a shift, you'll start to feel good for a bit, and then you'll have new symptoms come up. And generally that is the next timeline event that needs to be treated, or the next miasm coming up that needs to be treated. So that's an indication that you're ready to do something else. The life energy is bringing that up, and it wants that disease to be removed. All right, so I hope this helps with regards to healing reactions, and I will talk to you soon.